Today, I'll be reviewing AppointBee AI, which is a booking system that you can add to your clients' websites. You can sell this to local businesses. You can add this to your own websites. But basically what this does is it allows you to create booking widgets like you're seeing right here, where you can book appointments directly through this system. It will be registered in the backend, etc. So I'm going to show you full demo how this works. In case you're interested, make sure to check out the link in the description for the pricing, available coupons, also some bonuses if you pick this up through my link. So make sure to check that out. For now, let's dive into it and let me show you how it works. So like I said, you can create booking systems like this. So this is a widget. You also have inline forms, but here you can see this widget, for example, it says, hey there, welcome to our appointment booking service. What type of service are you interested in scheduling an appointment for? So in this case, it's on a dentist website. You can say, I'm interested, for example, in dental cleaning here. And then it says, please select a provider, the service provider. So in this case, only Dr. Pearl is doing these dental cleanings. So here it says, okay, choose your date. So in this field, you can say, okay, let's say I want to book an appointment at the 29th here, and I want to have an appointment at 11 a.m. And you can see, okay, continue. And now it says, may I have your full name, please? So I can say, okay, my name is Tim or Tim Verdau. And I'm going to press enter. And then it says, okay, what's your contact number? We will need it to confirm your appointment. So here I can fill out my phone number. I press enter. And then, okay, it's an invalid input. So I'm going to say, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's try this one. And then what is your email address? So I'm going to do tim@timverdau.com. And I'm going to present. And now it says, hey, thank you for sharing your contact information with us. We promise to keep it safe and secure. Do you have any specific preferences or requirements for this appointment? So let's say people say yes, then they can type their message. I need a special treatment. And they press enter here. And now it says here, okay, if everything looks good, please click confirm to proceed with the booking. Looking forward to seeing you on October the 29th at 11 a.m. for your dental cleaning appointment with Pearl. And I'm going to hit confirm. And now my booking here, we have received your appointment. Thanks. Your booking is confirmed. So that's the first thing here. That's how you can have bookings on your website. Another way to have bookings on your website is like this. So when I scroll down here, oh, I need to set that up in the backend. So let me do that and come back. And there you go, I'm back. And now you can see it as well. Scroll down and now it's like an inline widget on your website. So now they can choose here, okay, I wanna have, for example, I wanna have teeth whitening in here. They can select the provider here and let's say another service, let's say root canal. Now you can see that Dr. Tom Hilfiger and Chris Jones is doing the root canal. Now you can specify that all in the backend. So this basically works exactly the same here, except for this widget also here, when I go and book an appointment, so let's say the 31st at 1 p.m. For this treatment here, you can see that this is going to cost $300. So here you can fill out this information. You can confirm your appointment again. So you can charge here. You can set the pricing in the backend as well. So you have the two options. You can use it like this with the booking system on the right side, or you can embed it on your website. You can manage that all in the backend. So let me show you the backend, how it works. So first of all, let me go through a logical order here because these are the three things that you need to set up in order to let your booking system work properly. Here. And the first thing that you want to set up is the services. So here you can see the services that you just could choose from the menu, like dental cleaning, cavity filling, root canal. But this can be anything. If it's for a plumbing, you can say plumbing services or whatever you are trying to book on your website. You can fill out these services in here. So in this case, it's for dental here. We have all dental services in here. So you set up your services. The second thing that you want to set up is your service provider. So here we have Tom, Molly, Pearl, and Chris. You can say, I want to add a service provider here. And you can say, this is, for example, Pintu here. And Pintu is delivering these services, is doing dental cleaning, is doing root canal, and is doing dental implants. And now you can see that these are now available to Pintu. You can book Pintu now to when we want to book these services in here. So you can also set the pricing here, additional pricing for each person, and then you can save your providers in here. Then the next thing that you want to do is you want to set the working hours. So in here you can say, okay, first of all, you can list this for specific service providers. So let's say if you want to have different times for Tom, you can set Tom for a different time. So if you want to set them for all the same time, you say no specific provider. But let's say you want to book Tom here, you want to set the times for Tom. Now you can say, for example, Tom is not working on Sunday and not working on Saturday, and he is having a break here. So the right side of the screen here is where you can set the breaks. Let's say I want to have a break on Monday, yes, and Tuesday, yes. Every day I want to have a break for Tom between 12 and 1 p.m. And now Tom has every day a break from 1 to 2 p.m. And he's available from Monday till Friday from 8 till 5. But you can also say he starts at 9. So you can specify that for each service provider, and then you can save the working hours. You can also set exceptional working days. So for example, here we have Tom again. You could say, for example, on Sunday, if Tom wants to work on Sunday, where he has a special service, you can say, okay, Sunday the 27th, Tom is working. And then also on the 3rd of November and the 10th of November, Tom is available. So now this will become available in Tom's calendar. Now you can also set non-working days. So for example, next week here on the 28th and 29th, Tom is not working, and you can save that in here, and then Tom will not be available. So you can set that for each and every service provider. Now, when somebody has booked, you go here to the appointment B here, where you can see all the bookings. So here you can see all the bookings. You can see here it's confirmed. This is the booking that we just saw in here. So we have active appointments, pending appointments, completed appointments, and removed appointments. And you can also filter that by status in here, but you can also open an appointment. So here you can see the details and edit it. So here you can see this is dental cleaning, is provider Pearl. But if you need to change this because there are there needs to be some changes, you can set this to Molly as well. You can change the price if it needs to. You can change everything in here, and you can save and update these fields in here. So that's the whole backend, where you can see all the appointments in here. You can also set this to not automatically approved, and then you simply open them, you check if this is available, and then you can say, okay, I'm gonna confirm the status, or it's being paid already, or it's pending. You can set the status in here, and then you can save each contact in here. Now let's go back to the settings, because I only showed you three settings, like the working hours, the services, and the service providers. But let's go from the top to the bottom. So it also comes here with the time settings. So here you have time settings for your calendar here. And these are basically some general settings, like the accessibility settings. Like when somebody cancels their appointment, you can send them to a specific page on your website. Now you can see here that this is a WordPress website. So this is also a plugin. I need to tell you that up front. This is not a SaaS. This is a WordPress plugin that you install on your WordPress website. Now you can install this on all subdomains. So let's say you have created subdomains for your clients on your own domain, you can still have this service on your client's website. I'm going to show you that in a second. But here you can set the home page or the thank you page, the cancel page, etc. You can set allow clients to cancel their appointments, yes or no. You can say how to confirm. So if you want to confirm it yourself, you can set this to no. You can say payment settings, payment required, yes or no. You can set that in here. And also you have the notification settings here of the emails that will be sent. So here you say, hey, we're pleased to confirm your appointment here. You can set a reminder here. If you say yes, you can set a reminder. Time for the client in hours in here, where you can set the email in here, and you can save your settings. Now, maybe you've seen OpenAI in here as well. It's also called AppointBee AI, but honestly, that AI, just forget about that name. It's not that great. It's just some additional AI features. Like right here, you can see, okay, you can fill out your OpenAI key, and then when you go to your theme settings inside of your plugin. Let me show you that quickly here. So when I go to appearance here and I go to, I think it's theme options, Yes, you can see here that you can rewrite the text for the page title, for example, or when you go to the contact us form, you can say, okay, I want to generate the address description in here and stuff like that. So there is an AI part, but in my opinion, you can neglect that. So going back to the settings here, we got the top one is the general. We got the Google Calendar where you can connect your Google Calendar through API settings in here, where you can also add a Google Calendar button if you like to have that, if you connect that. You can also open Google Calendar in the same window. You can say, I want to have that, yes or no. But basically here you can connect a Google Calendar. Then the next thing is SMS. So you can also connect with Nexmo SMS service so that when somebody has booked an appointment, that you send them an SMS automatically with your appointment is scheduled, see you soon, and the message in here that you can set up in here, save your settings, and then SMS will be sent out. You need to set up your SMTP settings in here. So inside of SMTP settings, this will be used to send your emails. And then the appearance, inside of the appearance part here, you could basically set up all of your settings regarding colors, fonts, etc. of your widget, how it will look like on the website. So as you can see, it's very flexible in colors, etc., where you can change everything. Now, then there's a form position in here. And what I need to tell up front is that AppointBee also comes with their own theme that you can install in your WordPress. And then you can use the settings that you're seeing right here. These settings, it says select AppointBee AI form position. Now, like I showed you here, and let me refresh this theme. This is the theme that you will be getting. I expect that this is the theme you can use for clients to set up clients' websites, etc., where you can set up the booking system. So I showed you here, and now it's showing here at the bottom, but you can change this actually. And let me show you, for example, this one here at the right side. What this will do is it will add it as a form banner at the top. So let's say you want to have a, let's make this black here, and then the font color white. Let's do it like this. Now, when I go back to the page, instead of having the form here at the bottom, when I refresh the page, it's going to take a few seconds so people land on your website. They can book their appointment still here. But after a few seconds, you will notice here at the top, boom, it says flat 50% discount on dental checkup. Get appointment now. So when I click on here, the appointment widget shows up and I can say, okay, I want to have a root canal here. I choose a service provider and I can continue. Here is the calendar and you can continue with your booking. So that's what you set up in here, where you want to have your form showing up on your website, and you can decide the colors as well. Now, you can also run this on client websites, and that comes with the AI embed code. So here is the AI embed code. You can use this code and you can add this to any website where you want the form to show up and where you want to have that chat booking system widget on your website. You simply add this code to your website and both will be available on your website. The bot settings can be changed here at the right side, where you can say, I want to have this at the left side of my website or the right side. I only want to have an icon, or I want to have an icon with text, for example. So here, that's what you're seeing here. This is the icon with text, book an appointment. You can set that up in here. Also the image section here, you can change that. You can set the settings here, like the heading text, the subheading, and the bot icon text, like book appointment. You can change that in here. And then finally, also, you can change the email settings. And this is basically where you can connect this to your MailChimp account so that you can also send automation from a MailChimp account. And currently, only MailChimp is supported. Now, one final thing that I want to show you here is also the transaction. So when people have paid, you can also see all the recent transactions will appear in here for their booking. So when they book, you can see that in here with the transactions. And that's basically what AppointBee is all about. It's a booking system, a WordPress plugin that you can add to your website, your clients' websites, to local businesses, etc., so that they have a full booking system ready for them, for their clients to book their services. Hey, again, In case you're interested, check out the link in the description for pricing, coupons, bonuses, and more. Also, please hit a thumbs up if this video was useful to you. And consider subscribing to my YouTube channel if you haven't done yet. I do a lot of product reviews with products like this and many others. So hit that notification bell to get notified each time I upload a new video. And for now, thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you in my next video. Talk soon. Cheers.